Hello everybody, my name's Yin. Guess what I'm gonna do?
You need me to ravage you. Don't worry, I'm fully equipped to play you.
These are the coolest toilets ever. I am happy. Guess what else?
You have to wait till I want it.
Anyways, let's get back to the game. Well, it looks like I'm gonna go get some stuff. So, in the last episode, we got telekinesis. Personally, is one of my favorites, other than the blowing everybody up. I want my aviary suit back. There.
Contains a variety of floating rings. The color of the ring denotes the type of object you need to throw it through in order to score a point. Vehicles go through blue, people through green, and the head of our very own Professor Genki through the pink ones. Score a point on every hoop within the time limit, and you win. Good luck. It's murder time. Fun time.
Okay, so I basically get the concept of the game. Mom?
Welcome to Professor Genki's Mind Over Murder! Brought to you in part by everybody's favorite alien overlord, Sinyak!
That's right, folks. The Maven of Mascot Mayhem has teamed up with the Conqueror of countless galaxies to create an all-new Pinky experience.
As folks at home know, by exploiting weaknesses in Zinyak's meticulously crafted simulation, our contestant has gained the power of telekinesis. But they will have to master the power of the mind to complete the challenges ahead of them today.
I can now see why the professor was so eager to join forces with Zinyak. This should make for an interesting addition to the Genki family of gamers.
Right you are, Bobby. So let's meet our contestant, the winner of Genki Bowl 7.
Yeah,
our favorite contestant, the President of the United States.
Or whatever bits are still floating around in space, right, Zach?
Too soon, Bobby. Too soon. Let's get to the action. So, Bobby, how do you think the addition of superpowers is going to affect the game?
A submachine gun is a fine weapon, but nothing compares to the unlocked potential of the human animal. Super speed, super jump, and moving things around with the power of your mind? I'm expecting high action and lots of flailing bodies.
Makes you wish you had superpowers, doesn't it, Bobby?
I'm just happy not to be stuck in a vat full of foul-smelling nutrient milk, reliving my worst fears for all of eternity.
You and me both, Bobby. You and me both.
Can you imagine Genki and Zinyak flying across the galaxy together, conquering worlds and abducting the biggest badasses each planet has to offer, and pitting them against each other in a superpowered fight to the death?
Bobby, are you feeling all right?
Or they could team up against an army of mascots, flaming mascots, armed with rocket launchers and RPGs.
That's a fine dream, Bobby, but as you know, the world's biggest badass was locked away years ago.
True, but we're not allowed to talk about that.
No, we're not, Bobby.
I'm still standing.
And that's it for our first match.
Excellent job by our contestants.
Well, that was fun.
Hey guys,
Now, there's a store I'm after called Leather and Lace. Before I go break out Mount Miller, I heard it's like all the way over fucking here. Yeah, it's this one. So, let's go up here. Make a big ass jump.
Sure thing.
Get the screaming eagle. Is this still a zombie cloud? Yeah, at least I think it's over here. I was totally right. Supposed to be a sexy body shop, but I am still not wearing underpants. Yes. Theater. Damn it.
Is anyone counting these pills?
Dip-de-doo. If you guys want me to shoot them more, instead of just doing cheap explosion, bye.
process.
Alrighty, let's go shoot people. I'll shoot these guys up here.
Reinforcements engaged.
Fun. That was so fun. I want to do something fun without it. Yeah, fun. Super fun. Oh, I need to change my guy a little bit. I'm closest to this one right here. I'm not like my jetpack. No, not really, actually. I'm just gonna look for it. Look for where it's lost. Oh! Look for my jet. Hold on, guys. I want to be right back. Alright, guys, I'm back. But we are back. I'm probably going to put an ad, like, right between this. So, yeah. I plan on doing a special on this. I need to go get the Merrick again. Oh, there's a store over here I want to take over to. Wondering. I won't hold up the store. Give me your money, bitch. Bye. Come here, you golden Sid.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. Let's go save Matt Miller.
Alright, we got Sid, so how do we use him to get Matt?
Are you really sure about this? I mean, I know he can help, but it's Matt Miller.
Kinsey, if you can help us find the others, then yes, I'm certain. Now, how does this work?
Well, I give Sid the proper cipher to connect to Matt's personal simulation, and he opens the gateway.
Alright, let's go get the kill. Better you than me.
No more traffic. You know, actually,
how am I supposed to rescue Matt without a weapon?
Well, you don't have superpowers either.
Whoa. Why the fuck are there giant words in my face?
It's a command prompt. Just give me a second.
Again?
Damn it! The camera's screwed up. You just have to deal with it.
This isn't my first time with a top-down tank rodeo. Kenzie, you gonna fix this or what?
I'm trying, but I'm not used to the code they're using. Give me a second.
Very well. Your futile attempts do entertain me, after all.
That had some style.
This is awesome.
Lots of firepower here, Kinsey.
Destroying the tower should destroy the tanks with it.
Miss Kensington is rather astute for a human.
Yeah, well, big towers controlling security on a linear path. Not very creative for your superior intelligence.
Touché.
one more to go.
This is fun.
Oh, where the pigs, by the way, Quincy?
For what?
Well, I'm in cyberspace and I haven't been turned into a sex doll or a toilet.
Dad, are you still mad about that? I said I was sorry.
Something kind of sticks with you in your nightmares.
That's a reference to a Saints Row 3 when you're taking down Matt Miller. That's a really funny reference. You get the Kinsey turns you into a toilet and then a sex doll.
Alright, last tower's going down.
Oh, I don't think it should be that easy.
He's made the tower invulnerable. Hang on, I'll find a workaround.
This would be awesome with an Oculus. I'm still trying to get enough money to get one. Save it? I want it.
Yet again, I am impressed by Miss Kensington. Well, this attempt is futile, but I've used humans.
Oh, look, an alien with a superiority complex. Surprising.
Well, this sentiment comes from more than just a zin. Death. Tomorrow, and tomorrow, and tomorrow.
Oh, great. Shakespeare.
To the last syllable of recorded time. And all our yesterdays have lighted fools the way of dust and dirt.
I am super good with bikes.
Life's but a walking shadow, a poor player that struts and frets his hour upon the stage. And then is heard no more. It is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury.
What idiot said that?
It's a quote from Macbeth.
Never did like that play. I don't really like it that much either. Oh, you'll find out why he knows that. The Zen, why he knows that. Timed, I didn't even notice.
You're coming up on Matt's prison.
And how am I getting him out without any weapons or a key?
Chances are it's not a standard behind bars through the prison. You'll just have to wing it.
Normally you yell at me when I wing it.
Oh, and since I can't see what's going on in there, Dad will be able to help you either.
Keep those reassurances coming.
Stupid tanks. You get an achievement from this, I think.
Your race will live on borrowed time, and will, through your violent actions, wind up extinct. Walk through the red door, however, and I will release the humans whom I have collected. I will give them amnesty, leave a ship for my fleet to do with as they see fit. However, in choosing this door, you will willingly submit yourself to execution.
Okay.
The moment where you can prove to be the savior of humanity, or its absolute destroyer.
No.
What is all this?
This is your life as it led you to this point. All your past violence, crimes, and losses on display to remind you of one simple fact. Regardless of what I have done to your world,
now, if you go through this door, you get an achievement. And then... I want to rip his head off, so...
What the hell is all this?
This is your life as it led you to this point.
Wait, is that Matt?
Trapped in technology he doesn't understand, in a cyber world he can't control.
Don't worry, Matt. I'll get you out.
Without Miss Kenzie. Very dumb. This is but a glimpse of what I have conquered. Ah, yes. I'm quite proud of this one.
What am I looking at?
Terror, as personified by your literary culture.
The dead pirate with a black parrot?
It's a raven.
Why does the pirate have a raven? Is this the island that pirate came from?
Must you continue to display your plebeian intelligence?
Ooh, guess I'm hitting a nerve.
I tire of this. Deal with her on your own. Ta-ta.
Deal with who? I... Pick up the phone and we'll get you out of there, Matt.
Well, that did. That was not a new experience at all. I have played Doom 3 and 2.
Like the idea of us sitting around. Shouldn't we be picking up Matt? The kid could be in trouble.
Hey, you gotta relax. The guy's in my sick haven, for God's sake. He can take care of himself.
You need to help him out. And you're the commander in chief.
That's a good point. Why didn't we do this earlier?
Oh, I did. I'm just not a big fan of Matt.
Kenzie!
Yeah. save Matt. Let's finish rescuing Matt. Actually, that's it for this episode. Leave a like and comment down below. Subscribe. Hope you guys enjoyed this whole series. It's super duper fun. So, yeah, see you guys in the next video.